What's the number one reason that new apps fail? It's not the idea. It's not the tech stack. In fact, I see it happen all the time with students in my Ship Your App in 4 Weeks cohort. They build amazing AI-powered apps and then launch to crickets. They've built the perfect product, but they have no one to sell it to. Well, don't worry, because in the next few minutes, I'm going to show you how to build an automated machine that finds endless streams of perfect customers begging for the exact app you've created. Most of us know it all starts with a Google search. Say you created a weight loss app and put site:reddit.com before that, you'll find significant Reddit threads related to your app that you could potentially get ideas from or post to. You can even refine this further, as you probably know, with tools, and go to past week, and you'll see people in the last week who are looking for tracker apps and the ability to lose fat. But I don't want to be searching through Google and Reddit. I want AI to help me do this, and that's what I'll show you right now. First of all, we'll make sure we're signed up for a free SerpApi account. It's basically a Google search API, meaning you can run this while you sleep. Now, I've already signed up and got my account, and it gives me something called an API key here. We'll use that in just a moment. Now we've got that up and running, to automate our Google searches, we're going to use Zapier to link it all together, because it's the most connected AI orchestration platform out there. And I'm going to create a new Zap, and we'll start with the trigger. Time of day doesn't really matter, but I'm happy to run it at midnight so I can wake up to new leads in the morning. Now we continue on and add a webhook this time. And in this case, we're actually going to get from our webhook. Configuring this to work with SerpApi is simple. First, we put the URL, serpapi.com/search. Now don't worry, I'm going to link up a post down below that will have this all ready for you to copy and paste if you want to do this kind of automation yourself. Next up, under query string params, we'll put engine, that's the search engine we're going to use, and that's going to be Google. Then we'll add another value, Q, and that's the query, and we're just going to copy what we used in Google, obviously a search related to our app. Then we add another one, and we add TBS, which stands for to be searched. And then we add QDR, don't ask what that stands for, :D, which basically means all the search results from the last 24 hours. That means every day I'll wake up and find people who are screaming out for my app on Reddit. Finally here, very important, we need to insert API underscore key, and we just simply copy that from our dashboard here in SerpApi. Once that's done, we go continue and we test the step, and you can see we have had, yes, success. Now, what this will pass back is a bunch of search results from Google. You'll see all of these are search results of relevant threads that have been found in the past 24 hours. This is great. Now we're going to pass it on to the next step. All right, here's where the fun begins. We're going to introduce looping by Zapier. If I type in loop at the top, you'll find the looping ability here, and we'll loop from text. And we'll go continue here, and the value to loop will simply be the URL from the results. We'll do /" here to make a map, and we'll go to our webhook here. And what we want to do is scroll down until we find right here the organic results redirect link, this one. We'll click this, click continue, and we'll go ahead and test the step. Now you'll see here it generates 10 different loops to roll over, and Zapier will go round and round until all the links are analyzed. Now we'll go inside the loop, and this is where it gets really fun. We'll add AI by Zapier. And in this case, you've got access to all the latest models, but I'm going to use Google because it can access the web, and we'll use Gemini 2.5 Flash because not only can it see things, but it's cheap as well. I'll select my credential, and then I'll write a prompt. Summarize, :, and then let's map in that URL right there. And of course, AI by Zapier, being as OCD as it is, tells me my prompt strength is weak. So we'll click to improve the prompt and let Zapier AI do the work. Ah, look at this. This is much better. As a content summarization expert, get the main ideas, key points, and give it in a clear, coherent manner in 3 to 5 sentences. My prompt is now okay. I think I can live with that. So let's generate a preview of the first result. And you can see here it's analyzed correctly. It actually got the link to the Lose It subreddit and tells me a little bit about that subreddit. Now, before we go ahead and add the next step, I'm actually going to create a Zapier table because this will help me to store everything I find each day. We'll call it App Ideal Customer. This is my research doc. Perfect. We'll create that table. We're going to add 3 fields. The first one will be link. We'll type URL in here and click create. Next one will be a long text field, and we'll just say summary. And the final one will be a superpower. Yes, in Zapier tables, you can use AI fields that generate things for you on the fly when a row is populated. So let's do that. We'll call this field suggested reply. As you can see here, it's already using OpenAI and it's included with my Zapier account. Now we'll create a quick prompt and I'll do it from scratch. You are a world-class marketer of my calorie tracking app called Track It, and you will think of a genius one or two sentence reply, perhaps with a little bit of humor, to market my app based on the contents of this Reddit thread. Okay, that's great. I'll put a colon at the end and then I'll just insert the summary here. So the summary will be carried into this AI field. Then I click done. That's it. Now we'll store the URL, the Reddit summary, and we'll have AI suggest a reply. Super easy. Now just one more step and we're about there. Underneath AI by Zapier, back in my Zap, I'll add one final step, and this will be a tables step. For the action event, we want to create a record. We'll continue, and then we choose the table ID, which of course will be our ideal customer table, and then we need to populate those fields in tables. So for the URL, we do /, we look inside the loop, and of course we look for that URL we used earlier. Next up, we want to go to the summary field, do /, again, look inside the AI analysis here, and look for the output of our AI. That was our AI-generated summary of the URL that we'll insert into the table. We'll click continue, we'll skip the test for now, and we'll click publish to get the Zap live. All right, it's live. Let's give it a test run. You'll see my Zap is ready over here, and my Zapier table is over here ready to receive data. So let's click test run at the top right here. And we can see that the test has run successfully, and it's now iterating through each loop. And here we can see immediately we've got a fantastic Zapier table that's getting populated, and on the fly, Zapier AI inside the table is generating replies for all these Reddit threads in real time. Absolutely amazing. Let's check the results. Let's look at this one, for instance, and we see the AI summary is that the thread discusses various methods users employ for calorie counting. Ah! Perfect for our ideal app user. And we can open it by clicking the URL. 15 hours ago, how do you guys count calories? These are customers screaming out at me. Now, because of this clever automation, it will not only have read the post, but it will also summarize all the comments. And of course, you can see here in the table, it will have generated me a suggested reply. Let's open it and look at this suggested reply. Why measure your success in guesswork when you can track it? The name of my app. With our app, even your sneaky sauces and midnight snacks can't hide, because honesty is the best calorie policy. I love that. Copy text. And now we could go over to that thread, and if we like, we could join the conversation and paste that in. I would always suggest that you're a human in the loop. I definitely would never suggest to post AI slop straight to Reddit. Although Zapier seems to have an integration for everything, including, yes, Reddit, create comment. But that would be awfully naughty and I can't possibly recommend it. Well, I hope that's given you some ideas on how you can find ideal customers for your apps. I get really excited about creating automations and AI integrations and orchestrating AI to do things just like this. I hope you do too. Leave me a comment down below. Let me know how you'll use it, or if you're launching an app soon and you're looking for even more ideas, I'd love to help you. Thanks so much for watching, and YouTube is showing a video on your screen now. You should watch next. Thanks.